I was on my way to talk about morning glories. I took a shortcut through the garden and had the misfortune of walking through a massive spider web. I was messing with the camera and didn't see it. Accidentally walked straight through it. I've still got it all over me. But I saw this giant spider and had to try to catch her before she climbed away. This is the largest Joro, probably the largest wild spider I've ever seen. And seeing this massive Joro, it made me remember another unexpected encounter. Now, most spiders give each other distance, but these two were on top of each other. Ironically, it looked like the garden spider was the invader. There are four garden spiders nearby, my friendly little neighbors, that I'm used to seeing tucked away in their corner homes. And this wasn't one of the ones that I knew. I checked after everyone was sitting in their web. The Joro was at the very top of the web, missing a leg segment. And that could be from a number of things. Being a spider's dangerous. Things wanting to eat you, and some of the things you're trying to eat biting back. Or maybe it was lost in a dispute with a garden spider. I watched them for a while, but I think my being there interrupted whatever was going on. My first thought was it could have been competition for the spot. If I was a spider, I'd probably want to build my web there too. The Joro never moved, but the garden spider appeared to be consuming and dismantling the web. The next day, they were both gone. The web was gone too. No trace of anything on the ground, in or around the tree. I haven't seen that garden spider since. It's harder to tell with the Joro because there are so many of them. Like most spiders and most everything else around here except for water moccasins and yellow jackets, her first instinct is to try to run and hide from me. But she can bite, and she will bite to protect herself. It's not much worse than a bee sting, but it's best practice not to be bitten. Again, she is invasive, but she is stunning. Beautiful yellow, gray-green bands, and that red contrast. She's eating well out here, and that's part of the concern. Competition. Is she eating what a native spider would be eating? Competing with native species for food and real estate? Competing with me for walking space? Walking outdoors is different now. Webs are part of daily life. 10 years ago, I saw my first Joro. Now I carry one of these. Spider web stick. Everywhere I go. It's just some bamboo I cut the branches off of to help clear a path through the Joro blockades. My wife is terrified of spiders. She always makes me walk first so I can find the webs. I've accepted that role as designated person who walks through the webs, but I feel bad when Rhea's riding in the chest carrier with me, getting spider webs in her face too. She can't reach her face well in the carrier and gets mad at me when I try to get them off her. That's where the spider web stick is handy. Something to hold out in front of you to catch the webs before the baby does. Invasive species arrive, they adapt, and sometimes they thrive in ways we can't ignore. I don't know what this means for our native spiders long term, and unfortunately, only time will tell.